Today I'm going to show you how to RTXify your GPU, so your older GPU can look as awesome as that new card you've desperately been looking out for but couldn't quite get your hands on yet. Welcome to Pixel Generator. Just like you, I've been looking at those new and shiny graphics card releases for months, just to be disappointed by the fact that we still can't find any at a reasonable price. So I had the idea to at least find a way to add that fresh and new design to the cards we are kind of stuck with. In this video, I'm going to show you a couple of ways on how to put this backplate on your card. These designs are fully scalable to fit any card, so it doesn't matter which GPU make or model you have. These are 3D printed parts, and I'm giving you the files you need for free. Yes, free. Everyone that likes free stuff better hit that like button right now. But don't worry, even if you don't have a 3D printer yourself, nor know anyone with one, there are 3D printing services out there that can easily handle that for you. Just upload the design to them and they'll send the part straight to your door. By wanting to make this as easy and accessible to you as possible, I ended up with two versions of this backplate, tailored to different printer setups. Because for a long time, I suffered an imaginary condition called small printer syndrome. I was always fighting to get things to fit on my tiny build plate. So I broke down the first design into separate pieces. On small printers, you can now print the parts one at a time, or on larger ones, this gives you the freedom to better position the parts on the bed or even make different parts their own separate color or material, giving you some creative freedom. I made all my fins black, but if you want to have the larger ones in one color and the middle ones in another color or material, go ahead and knock yourself out. I'm half German, so our fun rainbow colors are black, white, and gray. Just kidding, we can be fun too. But only if we have to. This first version comes with a plain printable half base plate. I added some guides for you to help position the frames. This first design and the second version both basically scale in a similar way. But to get this to scale perfectly with your exact card, you simply measure your card length and divide it by 2. I'll use my GTX 970 measurements here as an example. The card is 240mm long, divided by 2 is 120mm for 1/2 length, and it's 97mm wide. So once you place the parts on the build plate in your preferred slicer program, make sure to pay attention to the orientation for the length and the width, and also uncheck uniform scaling. These separate parts are for 100mm by 100mm half backplate. This means if you double up the parts, as mentioned before, and set them together, you end up with a 200mm long and 100mm wide backplate. The second version is much more locked down, but is also easier to make. The base plate already contains all the fins, only excluding the frame, which comes as one complete and seamless part. So you just need two parts to make a complete backplate. These parts are 200mm long and 100mm wide, so similar scaling comes into play here. Using the same example as before, on the 240mm long GTX 970, we simply set the length to 240mm or 240%, and again scale down the width to 97mm or 97%, and you're done. The only tricky part with this one is, if you have a card like my GTX 1070 for the win, with 265mm of length, and if you only have a 250mm long build area. Well yeah, we're right back to small printer syndrome, even though that's a fairly decent sized printer. So if you want to use this second version, you might have to use some tricks to make it work if your printer is too small to fit the part. The nice thing with this version is that there are no seams between the parts and everything is already set in place for you. No matter which version you go with, you can use simple super glue to assemble the backplate and keep all parts in place. But before you do that, hold off till the bonus round. It's likely you might want to change things up after that. Now that we have printed the parts and our GPU is eagerly awaiting its transformation, how can we attach this to the card now? Well, again, I have two methods for you. First would be to simply use a double-sided tape of some kind. I still had this 3M foam-like one at home that I used. And I can really recommend it. It sticks well, builds up some height to get distance from components, and it can also be removed again. I'll leave links to the materials used in the description, so you don't need to hunt around for it. Just distribute some pieces evenly around places that make sense, depending if you are placing it over an already existing backplate or just a bare PCB. Remove the protective layer, align everything, and gently push the backplate down. Or, You could also use small neodymium magnets. This could work good on cards that have exposed screw heads. I'm going to use this method on my GTX 1070 with its oddly shaped finned Alpha Cool water block backplate, but the screws stand out and I can't short out anything. So this should work just fine in this case. Whichever method you go with really depends on your card and your layout. Oh, almost forgot, there's a third and obvious option. Just lay it on top as it is. As long as you don't chuck your case around, gravity should do its thing. Okay, remember that bonus feature I promised you in the beginning? That extra special something you can do with this backplate that even the stock cards didn't come with? Let's get to that part and the place where you can get those free design files, right after we take a look at some nice pixel generator merch. Spring and summer are coming, so get ready to show off your new awesome t-shirt or keep warm with a comfortable hoodie. And there are many other great products you wouldn't even expect, like water bottles, clocks, or fridge magnets. I'm on RedBubble and Teespring, so you have the freedom to choose your preferred shop. The links to both are in the description below. This can help fund needed tools, materials, or products to make reviews for you guys. Thanks a ton for checking it out. Now back to the bonus. With the first version, you could either use the provided base plates, but you could also make your own by using a different material like plexiglass to fit the parts to. And this is exactly where the bonus part comes in. All those new cards are lacking one essential feature to make them way faster. And really everyone knows what that is. It's RGB, because that makes everything faster. Now jokes aside, it can make things look cooler or just add that little bit of extra something that makes you smile when you look at your case. Simply take a plexiglass sheet, paint it white first. The white will allow the light to distribute better throughout the sheet. Then cover it with black, except for the edges. Place an ARGB strip underneath the back edge and voila, edge lighting. Subtle, tasteful, and not too over the top. Or if you want that little bit more, you could print the frames in a clear filament. Go through the same steps as before, but mask the areas where the frames sit to get some RGB lit frames as well as the edge lighting. Both of these effects are not available on current stock Founders cards, so depending on your preference, you have quite some options here all around. You can find this design and parts I made for other video projects under thingiverse.com/pixel_generator. The links are in the description. Tips are also enabled for anyone that gets value out of this or feels generous enough to toss a coin into the virtual hat. Thanks if you do. Have fun with your new backplate. Hope you like it. Thanks for watching and subscribing. See you in the next one.